lecture, we are going to introduce the main concepts about game theory. Game theory is used to modeling strategic decisions where there is an element of uncertainty, which is related to decisions of other people or users. Game theory implies that each actor takes her personal decisions, taking into account the decision of other actors. Game theory is a mathematical modeling approach, often used to configure typical managerial decisions such as the launch of a new product, the reduction of a price to react to competitors' actions, the collaboration with partners and suppliers, the entrance in a new market, etc. Before investigating the main areas of application on game theory, it is important to fix some key and fundamental concepts. To fix the main concept, we are going to use the examples of two ICT players that were competing to impose the technological standard for movies, DVD versus Blu-ray. Player 1 launched the former, player 2 in turn the latter. On the basis of these basic examples, let's see which are the main concepts to take into account. The first issue to raise pertains to the group of players involved in the decision-making process. A game, by definition, implies at least two main actors or two main groups of actors. As a matter of fact, it is possible to use game theory also with a higher number of players, but it is important to identify them as first issues. We will consider a simple example with just two actors, respectively player 1 and player 2. The second issue pertains to the alternatives that each actor has as final decision. In our case, we identify two main technologies. In spite of the technology launched by the single player, each player could decide to maintain the own standard or to follow the standard of the counterpart, because they have expectations that counterpart standard would be the most adopted in the market. Thereby, each actor could use either Blu-ray or DVD. The third element pertains to the main goals of each actor, that allows to order the preferences. The ordering of preferences is quantified through the value that the specific decision is providing to the single actor, measured through the payoff matrix. Payoffs are the quantification of the value for the player and may be a monetary value or a qualitative measure of the utility. In the former case, the payoff is counting the expected revenues or the profit of each actor through the launch of the new standard. In the latter case, a Likert scale from 1, related to the lower utility, to 4, related to the higher utility, is used. Out of simplicity, in our example, we are going to use the second approach. For player 1, who launched DVD, the best option is maintaining DVD standard, non-entering in players 2 once. Player 1 is willing to be the only one with this standard because they are sure that their standard is the best, due to the low production cost. If there is not initial consensus about the standard, they could be able to show the real value to the customers, pushing competitors out of business. We are then giving value of 4 to this alternative. The second choice is also maintaining DVD standard, eventually in case that also player 2 is moving towards this standard. For player 1, it is definitely better to maintain its standard rather than shift to players 2-1. We are giving value of 3 to this alternative. The third choice is shifting to Blu-ray, but at least with a consensus on this standard, to achieve a common agreement and pursue economy of scales within the industry. We are giving value of 2 to this alternative. The worst choice is the case where player 1 is pushed towards Blu-ray, not its standard, but player 2 is doing the same, with the problem of learning new standards and making new investments and without any advantage at least of a common agreement. In this way, player 1 is competing for the achievement of the long-term advantage, but with the less known and perceived less optimal technology. We are thereby giving value of 1 to this alternative. As a matter of fact, we need to understand the preference ordering for player 2 as well. For example, we could expect that player 2 is looking for standard consensus, preferable on Blu-ray, but also on DVD. As a matter of fact, player 2 thinks that it is better to converge towards a single standard to minimize investments and costs, rather than competing on a standard. We are thereby giving payoffs to player 2 considering this view. Now we have our full payoff matrix. This is the pieces of information that each actor has about the overall game. On the basis of the information reported in the payoff matrix, each actor is taking her personal decision independently. In decision-making model through game theory, it is implied that the players need to take their decisions simultaneously and without any chance to communicate each other. Moreover, the game theory has the assumption that each game is not repeated, but run just once.